Hey, horse people. I might post this on my gun channel too, since there's builders and I get some input on problems. So I had this shed put in, and I want everybody to guess in the comments how much this cost. And I'll show you a couple videos and go through what we did here.
So, the boys were helping them.
All the little critters were out here helping fix the,
Hi, boys! I know! What are those big poles? So, they came out and dug the holes the other day. I said I'd kind of, videotape this project. They came out and dug the holes with the skid steer the other day, and, today they came out and framed it up. Did a nice job, everything square, good measurements. Put 4 80-pound bags of concrete in each hole, so these are pretty solid. I don't think they're coming out, but it's lined up. Horses, of course, they know, so if I get here, somebody's gonna see if it's not square. Is it square? Rick, they did a crappy job and they screwed it up. Whatever. So anytime you put something high with horses, they get a little nervous. They're not used to things high up. So they were back in the back. They had breakfast and were just chilling out. And then when they saw these guys pulling with the truck or something new, and then when they put these poles in, they were like, whoa, what's going on? What's high? See, they don't have predators coming attacking them from the air, so they get nervous when things are higher. So anyway, I'll add this into the project. Stakes are done. And just so you know what's going to happen here is they're going to have a bar across here up at the top there, and then the roof is just going to angle down. And this is going to be a covered area, which is going to be 20 feet out, and this barn is 30 foot wide. So it's a 30 by 20. Somebody give me an estimate on how much it cost. All right. I'm not sure, they had to cut something off, so I don't know what he's, if he's put indents. So what he's doing is he's welding evidently a plate up there. So when they weld the beams on, it gives them more welding surface on the plate. So he's putting a little bead to weld the plate on, I guess. And then that's going to be the bar that goes up across the top for the shingles to sit on. Hey, horse people. So the shed is in. I'm going to probably add this into the end of the shed project, but I wanted to make this just a video. Horses are all ready. I want to put some temporary panels along here, and then I'll just open that gate and the horses can come in here and they can use this as another run-in. So they just got finished putting in all the screws and put this in. I don't know. It probably took them, I'm going to say, 3, 6, 9. Probably a total no more than 12 hours. Probably closer to 9 or 10 hours. So they had to dig the holes. I did that. They put the framing in. They had to weld it. Then they had to wait for the sheets. The sheets came in, and then they put the trim on, and they finished it today. Well, anytime you have work done around horses, invest in one of these magnets. I got my socks and because I had my tennis shoes on from the gym, and I just slipped them off. So these magnets will pick up things on the ground, and you just kind of walk, and it'll pick up. And me walking around dragging this, all these were all laid out in this area where I was going to let my horses. This can puncture the sole wall if they get it, if they run. If it hits a rock, this can puncture. These are the welding sticks. This is a sharp piece of metal. Probably wouldn't hurt their foot. They would probably just mash it in. I might step on that if I'm out here barefooted. But you can tell there's lots of things. And you can tell all the little metal shavings that it's also picked up. So, and all I did was walk up and down and drag this whole area where the horses are going to be to pick up any loose screws or anything. So, what's the odds of the horse getting hurt? Maybe slim to none. I'm gonna put this dirt under some of my mats that's kind of banged down. So, I could just spread that out and it would wipe in, but I want to use it since they dug it out of the ground into something. So anyway, the horses have a nice new running shed. I'm going to put a temporary panel there, and then I'm going to put 3 or 4 panels here. I could just take down this fence, but I'll leave it just in case I have to lock them up either in here or out there. And so that's the shed. And you guys can guess how much the shed costs, but I just want to do a little safety tip on anytime you have work done around horses. The other thing that I was really aware about is anytime they were welding, I was out here shooing my horses off, because horses do not know not to look at the bright light of welding, and they'll burn their eye and go blind, and it'll hurt their eye. So you know, you're not supposed to stare at it, and they're not supposed to stare at it. But when they hear that and they see sparks, it makes them nervous and they stare at it. So don't ever let anybody weld around your horses. And anytime you have any work done, where they're cutting, screwing, welding, there's going to be all these pieces of crap that's going to be on the ground. And you want to try and get rid of that before your horse steps on it. Costs you a vet bill, makes them lame. You know, one of those go up too deep and do some major damage. You'd have to put a horse down if it didn't heal or got infected. So just not good. All right. And we'll end out there. Buddy, what do you think of your shed, boy? Stupid human. Ransom's over there. Ransom, what do you think about your new shed? Oh, buddy decided to talk to me now. Oh, now you want to talk to me. Now you want to be a good boy. I was talking to Ransom. I see how you are. All right, we'll end it there. So I got to go close the gate. Come on, you want to go with me? I got to close the gate. Come on. Mokey, come on. Hurry up. Dad's got to go close the gate. Come on. Come on, you can come up here. I know, it's okay. We got to go close the gate. So I just got finished doing Ransom's feet. Hose that off, clean it up. Poles are mounted. And Moki's going for a ride with me. And both the horses are out there eating because they both got nice, fresh pedicures. So now I gotta go close the gate. Oh my goodness! Oh my goodness! Dad overcorrected. Mokey fell off. Hang on, we're gonna go fast. I'm gonna go fast in my little red tractor. There we go, we're going fast, Mokey. Come on. Oh my goodness. Come on. Oh my goodness! Dad's trying to steer and work the camera. And hold Mokey can't. He's like, damn, Dad's driving like a crazy man. I can't even stay on. Oh my goodness, it's crazy driving. It's crazy driving. I know. Oh, I forgot my chopsticks are here. I gotta pick up my chopsticks. So the guy shut the gate nice. He locked both latches. I like good young kids that do shit right. Texas kids out here saying yes sir, no sir, doing shit right. Stay in the car, Smokey. Dad will be right back. Oh, nice. Here's freaking good Amazon. Here's a bright Amazon dude. You got a freaking thing that says right here, Amazon box packages. He can't lift it up and put it in here. He just throws it on the ground. Freaking left wing bullshit Amazon. No following directions. All right, Moki, we're going. Don't try to jump out. All right, you ready? Hang on, here we go. What side? You gotta pick a side. Moki, you're smart enough to put that Amazon package in the box. I don't know why the hell Amazon can't hire somebody that's smarter than that. I know. They're all a bunch of dummies, huh, Moki? Hang on, we're going off-road. We're going to start four-wheeling. Hang on. Dad, you need to get better shocks. I'm bouncing around like a hooker on nickel knife. All right, left turn. Hang on, you better shift your weight. We're turning. You better shift that weight, boy. So I have to use these jumper cables to jump my dead battery on my lawnmower off this golf cart battery. So, all right, we're done. Moki's back home. There's the materials that he come out next week to finish that up, put frame up. All right, we'll end it there.
So there's Moki on his little, they dropped, it's like 6 o'clock in the morning. I got up, Moki saw my light, came on. They dropped that equipment off to build this shed yesterday, and the horses were all involved in it. And evidently Moki's been out there looking for mice or something all night. So when I woke up, I saw him, I was like, all right, I just wanted to show you all that crazy cats got to get in everything.